I He's just been. No, he's. She had decided to.
6 o'clock, February the 17th, regular city council meeting nights. Welcome everyone. I'd like to ask everyone if they would to turn off or silence their cell phone if they would. Also, we're graced tonight by having the Boy Scouts, Pat 207 here with us tonight, I believe it is, and I'd like, along with their parents and sisters, and we're glad to have them with us, and they've agreed to come up and lead us in the pledge of the flag. So if all you scouts will come up to the front here, and we'll join you and stand with you and pledge the flag, okay?
It could be old business or new business. One of them would be actions to remove Angela Mullinax and Dana Miles from the insurance plan because neither meets the requirements set forth at GMA. Mr. Miles says he's only got a verbal agreement. His firm has been paid by the city of Cumming $860,094.11 in the past 3 years. Mr. Miles can pay his own health insurance. Item number two, hiring a full-time attorney with a yearly salary, office in City Hall, and provide benefits. This will save the city money. Number three, conflict of interest. Mr. Miles represented the city of Cumming in the last election, represented the mayor in Georgia Government Transparency Campaign Finance Commission, case 2012-0063. I think the Bar of Georgia and the Ethics Commission should look at this action. That's my three motions.
Okay, let's take them individually. Let's take the request under old business item one on the AG letter to the Attorney General. I hear a motion to be added on. Have a second. The motion is second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. All of you raise your hand is in favor. Anybody opposed? Unanimous with Councilman Curry absent, and I might add that Councilman Curry has got a health issue and been admitted to the hospital. Keep him in prayer. So we got the first item, and the second one was GMEBS, Georgia Municipal, with the add-on by the attorney. I have a motion for that. Have a second. Add-on. Have a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Do I have a list that you vote? I have. Motion by Councilman Pugh in a second, and two for, one didn't vote, and one opposed. That's the majority that, do I need to vote in on that since we only have two of the council that has voted?
I thought three is the majority.
We have a two for, and one that didn't vote, and one opposed.
So you need a three-person vote to have a vote. And so if those are abstaining from voting, or voting for, or against?
I'm not voting for the one.
So you're voting against voting on there? And that's 2-2 tie, and under your charter, you can break the tie.
I think since the council has recommended to be put on there at the request of Georgia Municipal, I will vote in favor of putting it on the agenda because I think it's to do with the Georgia Municipal Association, and I think it needs to be put on there. So I will vote to put it on there. Okay. All right. The other add-on was equipment security. I hear a motion we add that on to the agenda. Have a motion, have a second.
What is the, you're talking about equipment security or building security?
There's two different ones. It's equipment security. We have some viruses that has come into our computer recently, and we need to take security measures, to try to correct that, and that's the reason I wanted to put that on there and discuss that. So I have a motion to add that to the agenda. Do I have a second? Have a second. All in favor? 4-0. Councilman Curry, absent. Okay, I hear a motion on the request, Councilman Sexton. I think this is things that's been just covered in the subpoenas that were sent here in request of myself, Angie Mullinax, and Dan Miles. All this is covered in the subpoena.
I still make a motion that be added on.
You making a motion? Do I have a second? Motion dies for lack of a second. Okay, now I hear a motion to adopt the agenda as presented. Amen. Have a motion. Have a second. Have a second. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? 3-1. Councilman Sexton opposed with Councilman Perry absent. Okay, the third item on the agenda is consideration of executive session, Councilman.
Mr. Mayor, we need an executive session or request one, please, for pending litigation.
Need executive session for litigation?
Pending litigation, yes, sir.
Okay. Now I hear a motion to adjourn. Adjourn to go into executive session. I have a motion, I have a second. All in favor? Adjourn. We'll try not to be very long.
He raised his hand twice and voted twice. They also adjourned. They adjourned for executive session. I know it should have been a recess for executive session.
If they come back into the meeting, then they've got so illegally because it's not an adequate.
They adjourned the meeting.
Yeah, they adjourned the meeting. Give them one of the books.
You can't adjourn. Mr. Amos knows the difference.
contact order.
A second. All in favor, raise your hand. Announce. Okay, item four is consideration adoption of the following meeting minutes. A was be the regular council meeting January the 20th, 2015. I assume everybody got a copy. If no correction, chair will entertain a motion. And a motion is second. All in favor? Any opposed? Unanimous. Item B, special call meeting January the 20th. Is there a motion?
No.
Have a second?
Yeah.
All in favor? Should you find a read your hand?
No opposed?
Unanimous. Item five, acknowledgments, proclamation, resolution, there being none, going to old business. Item one, requested by Attorney Banner Miles, Attorney General Letter, request and response.
Mayor, can I approach and pass these out?
Yes, sir.
This is just an attempt to update the council on where we are. I'm not requesting any action at this time from the council. In your packet that I've just handed you is a copy of our original letter request to the Attorney General. There's also a copy of the Attorney General's response. And there's a copy of our letter from last week requesting that the Attorney General respond to some of the issues that the Attorney General raised and requested on the previous of his decision. We've not gotten a response from the Attorney General related to the letter that we sent last week, which is the top of your packet. And again, this is just on the agenda for informational items, so I think the council is apprised of what the status is. Thank you very much.
It is.
Thank you, Dan. No action to be taken, right?
That's correct.
Okay. Under item 07, administration, we have a resolution to designate a records officer. If you'll notice in your packet responsibilities, whereas the provisions of the Georgia Records Act, Section 50-1870, allows the designation of the records officer to whom all requests be made, and it goes on down all the whereas is about. The bottom line is that it's been recommended by staff that Crystal Ledford be made the records officer of the city of Cumming, and be placed in all of the information with the city coming, including the website, the officer will go to request some information and records. And that'll require a resolution to be drawn up by council in reference to that. Basically, this is the resolution that's in your packet. So the chair will entertain a motion to that effect. I have a motion from Quincy. Do I have a second? Second from Willis. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. With Councilman Curry absent. Item two, hiring of an alternate counsel. Cruiser Mitchell is requested LLP from, I think Kevin Dallas going to present this.
Mr. Mayor, thank you, members of the council. This is an item has been added on for your ratification that previously taken. I'll explain how this came up. As the city knows, received anti-libel notice from council who I think at least formerly represented Councilman Sexton. And as a result of that, the city's insurance carrier hired a law firm, Cruiser Mitchell, to represent the city in regards to any kind of potential litigation that might have been arising out of that. After that, alternate counsel was retained by the insurance carrier. The city received three subpoenas and documents from the U.S. Attorney's Office. One of them included requests for information about Daniel Miles, who is, of course, the city attorney. When we received that subpoena, I immediately notified the city administrator that my law firm, I'm a partner of Mr. Miles, that my law firm should not be the one that represents the city in responding to that those subpoenas. Obviously, those subpoenas were issued to the city. The city is our client as long as Mr. Miles is the city attorney. But because he was mentioned in those subpoenas, it was my determination that we could not represent the city in that. So we recommended the hiring of another firm to represent the city's interest in responding to that subpoena. Because of the familiarity of Cruiser Mitchell with regard to the issues that involved the anti-litem notice that was received from Mr. Dillard, on behalf of Councilman Sexton, it was my recommendation that so that the city could handle this efficiently, that Cruiser and Mitchell be the law firm that the city retained to represent the city's interest with regard to those subpoenas and help the city in responding to those subpoenas. Upon that recommendation, the city administrator then engaged Cruiser and Mitchell, and I believe that under the charter and your administration provisions of the code that he has the authority to do that. But it's our recommendation that the council ratify that decision at this point, so there's no question as to the propriety of Cruiser Mitchell assisting the city and representing the city's interest when it comes to the response to those subpoenas. Are there any questions?
Who's paying for this? The city?
At this point, my understanding is that the city has not received a bill for that. And I don't mean to be coy about that, Councilman Sexton. My understanding is that when Cruiser and Mitchell submits a bill, they are going to submit it to the city's insurance carrier, and then the city's insurance carrier will determine whether or not it's part of the covered expense. I just don't know the answer to the question at this point. I am sure that the city, if the bill ultimately comes to the city, would pay the bill, which is one of the reasons we want to have this ratification in place. But at this point, it's not determined whether the city is going to have to pay anything for Cruiser and Mitchell services with regards to these subpoenas or not.
Well, I've got a bill I'd like to present to somebody.
Okay.
Would that be the city or would that be the insurance company?
I didn't hear your question.
I said, I've got a bill I'd like to present to somebody. I don't know whether that's going to be the city or the insurance company.
Well, I'm sure if you wanted to try and put that on to an agenda in the future, we could try and put that on to an agenda in the future or have that be considered. But right now, the issue is the Cruiser and Mitchell, the hiring of Cruiser and Mitchell to represent the city and first when it comes to the subpoenas.
But we don't know who's going to pay for it. Is that correct? Your answer, you don't know whether it's the insurance company or the city?
I don't know whether the city will ever receive a bill for it. I think it's the best response that I can give. I don't know whether the insurance company will pay for it. I don't know whether Cruiser and Mitchell will ever even submit a bill to the city if the insurance company doesn't.
Ms. Woodward's here tonight. Do you think she can answer that question?
I suppose that she might be able to if the insurance company doesn't pay for it. Although she's not, my understanding is she's not the partner responsible for that client, so I'm not sure if it's actually her decision ultimately.
So we don't know anything, do we?
No, sir, that's not what I told you at all. What I told you is that the city attorney's office had a conflict, did the proper thing under the circumstances, announced that conflict, recommended the alternate counsel be hired to deal with those subpoenas. What we don't know is whether or not the insurance company will pay for it.
We have the agent here, can she answer?
I don't know, you'd have to ask the agent.
She's sitting right back there. Gail, can you answer that question?
To the best of my knowledge, yes. I can tell you right now, everything that has been received in relation to anything that's going on with Mr. Sexton has been submitted to CNA for review. And right now, there has been no determination as to what bills will be paid by CMA and what will not be, because it's under coverage review. So if it turns out that it's a covered matter, then the insurance company will pay the bills that will be submitted from Cruiser Metro. But right now, it's still under review, it's still being investigated. There haven't been any specific, you know, yes, this is covered, no, this is not covered decisions made by the insurance company yet. So I'm like Kevin, I can't give you a specific yes or no answer as to whether or not all of the bills submitted by Cruiser Metro will be paid by CNA, but I do know that anything related to you has been submitted to CNA. They're aware of everything. They hire Cruiser Metro because of the conflict of interest that they have, and everything's being reviewed right now.
Any other questions? So, Mr. Mayor, the request is that the city authorize the retention of Cruiser Mitchell for this conflict issue and any other conflict issues that come up. Because what I don't want to do is be in a situation where if something comes up next week and we have to do, under the rules of professional conduct, announce that we have a conflict and have somebody else represent the city, I want to make sure we don't have to come back and do this every single time. So the request would be for Cruiser Mitchell to be authorized to be the conflict counsel to represent the city. They're not the city attorney, but to be the conflict counsel to represent the city in the event that the office of the city attorney has a conflict and can't fulfill its duties.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, we have a recommendation to hire alternate counsel of Cruiser Mission LLP firm to represent the city in the absence of Dana Miles' law firm. Miles, Astor, Talbot law firm. That takes the regular city attorney out of conflict, correct? I think that's correct. Chairman, entertain a motion. Mr. Council, have a motion and second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raise your hand. Any opposed? 3-1, Councilman Sexton opposed. Councilman Curry absent. Okay, item 3, security upgrade, City Hall. Most recently, we've had some allegations that there's been illegal meetings held, and we've had security in the building and outside the building that was put in when the building was built and dedicated for over 12 years ago. This equipment has become obsolete, so to speak. Request is that we upgrade our security system. And we've had several quotes, and it ranged anywhere from $8,000 to $10,000 to upgrade. Obviously, that's not in the budget. That'll have to come out of contingency, but I think it's something that's needed to protect everybody at City Hall. So the chair will entertain a motion to that.
Security and also to enhance that only city employees have a key card.
I have a motion to do the security upgrade. Councilman Sexton has obviously wanted to amend it. Is that what we got?
As part of security, he's got the key and he's got the card.
Have a motion to have a second.
Okay.
Second. For discussion. We might ask, because that's part of the process that's going on now, the request of all the documents of anybody who has a key or a swipe card. And since that's all under investigation, I'm not sure that anybody with the city of Cumming that's not an employee has a key or a swipe card. So I don't think that'd be a conflict anyway there, but it's up for discussion. Anybody have any thoughts about that?
I don't know.
Okay. We got a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Let me get the ones for it. You raise your hand if you're for it. Commission. I have two. All opposed? Okay. Is it for it? I have a two and two again. So. So it's up to myself to break that tie.
Yes, sir, on that motion.
Okay. I will go at the recommendation of the staff here to Chad has looked at this and talked to several people, and certainly we want to secure the building and the exterior as well as the interior. And I'll vote for what the staff has recommended to upgrade security, and that may well mean what you've alluded to is reference to the swap cards and the entry key. So I have a motion and a second and a 2-2 vote, and I'll break the tie by voting for the security upgrade to City Hall. So the motion carries.
Mr. Mayor, just a point of order. I just want to make sure that you understand that by voting to break that tie in that way, it approves the addition made by, or it approves the motion made by Councilman Sexton, which is to approve the security upgrade, spending that money, and also to ensure that access cards are only given to city employees.
Exactly what he's stating.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to make sure.
The security upgrade as presented by the staff doesn't say what was amended by Councilman Sexton.
That's exactly my point.
That was what I was saying. We have a 2-2 vote, and I'm voting for what the staff would recommend, the security upgrade.
But the motion on the floor is the security upgrade plus removing the access card. So
that's correct.
So by voting in favor of that, you're not voting on just what the staff recommended, you're voting on Councilman Sexton's motion, which is the staff recommendation plus removal of the access card. That's what's on the floor right now. And obviously, whichever way you want to vote is your choice, Mr. Mayor, but what you said was I'm just voting in favor of the staff recommendation. That's not what's on the floor right now. What's on the floor is Councilman Sexton's motion.
Well, I would vote. Can I get a withdrawal and a motion and a second to start over? Can I have a withdrawal?
Only the maker of the motion would choose to withdraw it at this point in time. So I think that there would have to be a vote on that motion, either up or down, unless Councilman Sexton chooses to withdraw.
Let's vote. Okay. Councilman Sexton has made a motion then that we go with security, but the keys will only be for City Hall, will be the employees only. And I think that's the way it is anyway, but Councilman's made that motion. They have a second.
Second.
Okay, I've got a motion and a second.
Right, it's the same motion. It's already second. The motion's Councilman and Q did second.
Okay. All in favor? Signify by raising your hand. We have two. All opposed? We have two. It's a 2-2.
Right.
Okay. I do not wish to vote to affirm that motion. The motion would die for lack of a majority.
You would need to vote against it, Mr. Mayor, before you have to break the tie. So would you vote yea or nay?
I vote no, but I don't vote to affirm the motion, so I vote no.
Okay, when that motion fails, the issue is whether there's an alternative motion on this item, different from what Councilman Sexton brought up or not. If not, then you move on to the next agenda item. But if someone has an alternative motion on this agenda item, it would be considered now. If there are no other motions on this item, then you move on to the next agenda item.
Okay, to have a motion as is presented on the packet with security upgrade.
We're going to vote again.
We're voting on the other.
I'm voting
for the security upgrade. You?
Security.
Got a motion to have a second.
Okay.
Liz, did you vote?
Oh, we haven't voted yet. He was trying to say.
He made a motion.
No, John D. did.
John D. voted on the other motion. He can't vote on this one.
John D. can make a new motion, which he just did. Quincy seconded it, as I heard it. Maybe.
I didn't hear anything, okay.
Yeah.
Got a motion.
Councilman Q made the motion, Councilman Holton seconded. Not happy, so
now that's a security upgrade.
Security upgrade, just like the Sony packet.
Yeah.
I think we got a motion and a second. In discussion. I don't know where Councilman Sexton was talking about just employees where elected officials would have a key to the building or not. It's very vague the way he explained that. But anyway, currently they have a key, and I don't know, I think it'd be best to go with this security upgrade that's presented by the staff. So we'll have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Do you vote for it, John D.?
Yep.
Okay. Any opposed?
I'm for it.
Three for and one against.
I'm for it.
Okay, item four, 2015 property and liability insurance, Gail Peter.
Of the five, I would recommend you stay where you are with Selective on all the lines except your police and public officials, and stay with National Fire on those two lines. The other three carriers have pretty much indicated they didn't feel like they could be competitive with what you're currently paying. So I would say staying where you are is a good thing. The limits, the limits and the deductibles would stay exactly as they were last year. It would include earthquake like it did last year. The premium would be, comparative to last year, would be about a 4.3% increase in premium. It went from $174,397 to $181,941. This represents a $7,544 increase over last year.
Okay. Just same coverage as we had last year?
Yes, sir. Everything's identical to what you had last year.
Yes, sir. How much rate increase?
It's a 4.3%.
That's about the last one. It goes from $174,397 during 2014 to $181,941. Is that what you got?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, we have a recommendation by our agent, and that's Selective. Group insurance, same as we have now.
Yes, sir. Selective on everything except the law enforcement liability and the public officials liability. And those are with National Fire.
All right, Chair, I entertain a motion.
I'm going to review it.
I mean, you're in the insurance of the Herald's recommendation on the property and liability insurance. Chairman, entertain a motion.
I make a motion.
I second it.
Have a motion, have a second, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous, thank you, Gabe. Okay, GMEB, yes, council.
Mayor, may I approach and hand this up?
Yes, sir.
Mayor, members of the council, this is an ordinance that has been prepared by GMPDS, which is the Georgia Municipal Employees Benefits System, that has been sent to us, asking the council to take action in ordinance form that basically repeats what you did last September in resolution form. There is a state law that requires on these type of elections that may be done by ordinance. It was originally sent to us last fall by GMEBS, and they said, please pass it as a resolution or an ordinance. You passed it as a resolution. They now sent it back to us and said, please pass the same thing as an ordinance. There also are a couple of errors in the declarations page that are being corrected as part of this ordinance. I have read through it and have recommended that the City Council consider approving it, because basically it's just redoing what you did last September in ordinance form as opposed to resolution form and then correcting what errors are present. Attached to it is a whole bunch of documents that are exhibits, but the ordinance itself is just the first two pages. Glad to answer any questions.
Well, it's a big packet there, and it's got all the lawyer lambo and limbo in it, so I probably don't understand it anyway. So. But it's a recommendation of the GMA that that we act on this, correct?
Yes, sir, and they just sent that to Mr. Higgins in the last week, and so that's why it wasn't even packed for now.
This is to replace a resolution that was done last year.
In September of 2014, last year, y'all passed a resolution that basically does the same thing as ordinance does.
All right, what's the pleasure of the board? Chairman, entertain a motion. Have a motion. Have a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Councilman, very nice. Thank you, Mayor. Okay, item six is equipment security. I put this on there because we've had computer viruses recently, and it's like from one office to another office, employees sending emails and it says, click quick, or Joe needs to see you, or Pam requests this, and that's not true. It's a virus that's coming through our system. So what I would like to do is to authorize the city manager and administrator to draw up a resolution that would basically not allow anyone to use the city of Cumming computers, copy machines, or any other equipment in the city, in any of the city offices, other than employees in that department. And also, if your passcode is not current and hadn't been replaced recently, that you'd be required to put a new code in your computer, and also put a code in your computer, change that code every 6 months. So if your code gets out, I think we're having problems with maybe some people coming in and maybe hook up the computer, or we don't know what kind of virus, but we know we've had a lot of problems here at City Hall, and Chad has stayed busy for a long time trying to keep the viruses out. And I think this is one of the suggestions that was made to try to help that and keep anybody off of any of the city equipment other than just employees in that department. So that's the reason that I put that on there, to try to protect the city and its employees. So the chair will entertain a motion that requests the city manager administrator draw up a resolution protecting those departments from potential and problem down the road. I'll entertain a motion. Have a motion from Quincy, have a second.
Second.
Second from John D. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Councilman Curry, absent. Okay, under planning and zoning, we have a request, item number 2014346, Catherine Angus, zoning request. Mr. Morgan?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mayor, members of council. If you will refer to your packet, Kathleen has made application to the proper authorities to rezone property she owns at 102 Brooks Farm Drive, approximately 4.029 acres more or less, from office professional to single family residential for the purpose of constructing a single family dwelling in which to reside. The property is currently vacant. To the best of our knowledge, the proposed rezoning would not be detrimental to the surrounding property owners' value, use, or enjoyment of their properties. Proposed rezoning is in conformance with the city upcoming comprehensive and future land use plans. The planning board held a public hearing on January 20th, 2015, and with no public comments, voted unanimously to recommend approval of proposed rezoning with the following three conditions. Number one, prior to the issuance of a residential building permit, the property owner must dedicate 12 feet of property along Brooks Farm Drive to the city for the purpose of additional road right-of-way. Condition number two, prior to the issuance of a residential building permit, the property owner must pay the city for necessary road infrastructure improvements to Brooks Farm Drive, the amount of $71,294.24. Condition number three, prior to the issuance of a residential building permit, the property owner must pay to the city a pro rata share of $31,518.30 for the extension of the sanitary sewer line to serve the new Brooks Farm Drive lots, plus the water meter and strip tap fees for their lots. Be happy to answer any questions, and Mr. Mayor, we will require a public hearing for this item.
Council, any questions? Okay. I hear a motion to open for public hearing.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? 4-0 with Councilman Curry, absent. Anyone here like to speak in favor of zoning application 2014346? Anyone like to speak in opposition? I hear a motion that public hearing be closed. Have a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Call meeting back to order. The request is zoning 2014346, Catherine Amos. It's been recommended by the board. Want suppression? Council. I have a hear a motion.
I make a motion that we rezone the call.
I have a motion by Lewis to honor the request of planning zoning board. I have a second. Second by Nydia. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. 4-0. Councilman Curry, absent.
Sir, that is with conditions as proposed by the planning board, correct?
Recommendation of the planning board.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, item two, hiring of counsel to represent the Zoning Board of Appeals. Kevin?
Mr. Mayor, I'm here before you again regarding a matter of hiring separate counsel. This is something that state law requires. Whenever there is a situation where something is appealed from the Zoning Board of Appeals, if it proceeds by something called a petition for writ of certiorari to the Superior Court, The city is involved in that, as is the zoning board of appeals. And state law is very clear and says that the city attorney or whoever is representing the city cannot represent the zoning board of appeals. Your clerk, Mr. Jeff Honey, has done an admirable job of representing the zoning board of appeals up to this point, but the time has come and an appeal is currently pending in the Superior Court that we believe council needs to be retained to represent him. I have made the recommendation that Robert Jackson Wilson of the law firm of Webb, Tanner, Powell, and Wilson be the council retained to represent the zoning board of appeals in any matters that require its representation at the Superior Court level. I know Mr. Jackson had a chance to litigate with him both on the same side of and against that law firm in previous cases, and he's a very good municipal law attorney, and I think he'll do a fine job with his own board. Any questions about that?
And this is due to the fact that y'all represent us on the this board of appeal.
We represent, exactly, your mayor, we represent the city. But state law requires that the zoning board of appeals have a different attorney, if it's going to have an attorney, represented. The alternative is that Mr. Honey will continue to proceed without an attorney. We just believe he's done a great job. He really has at this point. We just believe it's got to be the point where some legal issues have come up. The council would be good to guide the zoning board of appeals to their office.
And he would be representing the city also.
Who? Mr. Wilson?
Board of Appeals, that is the city.
Well, but they're two separate entities under our process. And so when it comes to responding to the things that go to the zoning board of appeals, Mr. Wilson has to respond to those and will continue to represent the city as a whole body.
Okay. Something conflict of interest, so we have to do it, right?
Well, it is. Yes, state law requires it. If we're going to have an attorney to represent the zoning board of appeals, and it's our recommendation that we do, the law requires that it not be the same law office that represents the city.
Okay. What's his fees going to be?
$225 per hour is the rate that Mr. Wilson is charging for the representation.
All right. The council have any questions? Chair, entertain a motion to hire Jack Wilson as the lawyer to represent the city and the board of appeals. Have a motion, have a second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Councilman Curry, absent. Okay, item C under utilities. This is an item here of South County IGA intake generator. For the raw water intake on Lake Lanier. This is something that was voted on in SPLOS 7 and approved, and we're working on an intergovernmental agreement with the county. And several items that we need to talk about in that IGA, and Chairman Amos is here with the commissioners, and one of the items that I found in the IGA agreement was that if the county decided to terminate their agreement with the city of Cumming and not use water, the county will take the generator back. Something to that effect. I don't think that's the way it should be, and I don't think that's probably the way the board meant for it to be, but there's some things that we need to talk about, and our attorney will get back and send that. I thought it was too easy when y'all sent the agreement over here and it's already signed. I thought it would be too easy for us. So anyway, we're gonna review it and get everything straightened out and get it back to you. It's gonna be probably another year and a half before we're able to implement the funds, get the funds to do it anyway, because we know the courthouse and jail funds has got to come in before that happens. That's probably going to be about a year and a half. Anyway, I'd like to table that for the next week. We'll hear a motion.
Second.
All in favor? Unanimous. Captain. Very absent. Okay, item two request to advertise water line on Castleberry Road.
John Hearn, Director of Utilities. Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council, if you've gone down Castleberry Road recently, you've seen some of the clearing that's going on. Forsyth County has let the contract, signed a notice to proceed with a company called Vertical Earth to widen Castleberry Road from the city limits down to Ledford Road. And the city's existing water line is in conflict with that new road design, and we have planned, we have a set of plans ready to go out for bids to replace this water line. We're asking for permission to advertise for bids over the next month, and we'll present at the next council meeting prices to move this water line to make way for the new road line.
Okay, you're asking the city to authorize you to go for bids on it, correct?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
That goes from what point on Castleberry Road?
Well, Castleberry Road could be widened from the city limits down to Bethelby Road. Our city water line is just short of Bethelby Road. It's not quite that long. Just maybe a half mile short of Bethelby Road, but it's still quite a ways to replace that water line. It would be an 18-inch water line. Yes, sir.
All right, have a request to advertise for bids for Castleberry Road water line replacement. I hear a motion. Motion, I have a second. Second, point of discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous with Councilman Curry absent.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor, the City Council.
Concludes the agenda. I hear a motion to adjourn. Second. All in favor? Any opposed? 4-0, meet the adjourned. Thank you very much. Thank you all for coming.
Well, if you're at one, you know, twice now.
Mr. Sexton?
Turn it up. Reaction.
to tonight?
To my motion?
Yes.
Okay. The other four councils endorsed what's going on, which is Angie Mother next, neither Dana Miles or employees of the city of Cumming. So they're endorsing them to have free insurance. That's the bottom line. I tried to correct that. I've been trying to since August of 2014. I've been unsuccessful. The bottom line has been that because I even brought it up, is that they've been on railroad to impeachment by first forming an impartial panel to investigate me, which is the city attorney who's on that panel. That's not impartial. That's as partial as you can get, the city attorney. So the other councilmen are endorsing the actions by the council.
You think by them not seconding your motion that that's their seal of approval?
Yeah, it is. Mine was to remove them.
Where's the status of the investigation into your impeachment stand, as you understand?
I've got a letter here. I haven't had time to read it, but it's a letter from the Attorney General. So they didn't impeach me tonight, so I guess it's a dead issue.
Do you expect that you will or no?
No, I won't be impeached. I've not done anything.
So you did not release the documents?
No. It's public record if I did.
Appreciate your time, sir. Thank you, yes, Sam. Where's the mayor? Did he sneak off?
Yeah, he took good stuff.
Where did the mayor go? I try to grab one of the council members as they missed her.
Getting his new keys.
I'm sure he's home. He's supposed to be getting me a SWAT keys, and his girlfriend has one.
In the world of just, you know, law and the attorney general, everything that happened after that point didn't happen. They need to come back and do every bit of that again.
Okay.
Because they adjourned the meeting. And that's why I tell the Forsyth County News, because we want you to report on when there are potential violations of the law, because it's very pertinent to what's going on here and now. So I hope y'all will run a story on that.
Yeah, I'll look into it.
Hope so. Thank you.
Mr. Mayor?
Mr. Mayor, you got
Mr.
a
Mayor, do you have one moment?
Do you have
one moment
just
to discuss tonight, Mr. Mayor?
Hey, I've got a SWAT car they found out on the street. Maybe I should try that.
I'm going to have a new SWAT car.
You might just try opening that door. I think it goes down the same hallway, but I'm not positive. Oh, no luck. Okay. Oh, well. We tried. He ran, which is not surprising.
I lost blood on the property at my house in Wendy. I was thinking several days before the way they were reporting
it. They talked about it. They talked about snow.
Yeah. You know, I remember in the 70s, I've been cold. A couple that were worried.
I've been out.
It shut it down.
I've been out longer than that. I've been
you go so many years with these pine trees and they don't drop those limbs.
Yeah, I mean.
And then you get one.